Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss about dicyclomine, how this drug acts as antispasmodic. Dicyclomine is one of the anticholinergic agent. Because of block of cholinergic receptors, it produces the muscle relaxation. So it acts as antispasmodic, particularly in the treatment of irritable bowel syndrome, IBS, dicyclomine can be used. This is the structure of dicyclomine. Here you can observe two cyclic ring systems which are attached directly. So this is nothing but the bicyclohexyl ring system, which is further attached with the carboxylic acid in the form of ester. So dicyclomine is a bicyclohexyl carboxylate derivative. On the other side, we can observe the alkyl moiety, which is made up of ethyl chain attached with the diethyl amino group. So this is nothing but NN diethyl amino ethyl side chain. So that is the dicyclomine. Dicyclomine is a anticholinergic with ester functionality. Now let us see how this drug acts as antispasmodic. At the GA tract, cholinergic transmission produces the muscle contraction. So at the GA smooth muscle, muscarinic receptors are present, which are activated by acetylcholine. This acetylcholine is released from the cholinergic neurons, which act on the muscarinic receptors. These muscarinic receptors are G protein coupled receptors, which are coupled with three subunits alpha, beta, gamma. Now the acetylcholine, which is stored into the presynaptic nerve terminals, can be released and act on the muscarinic receptors. When the action potential reaches to the nerve terminal, calcium mediated exocytosis is going to take place, where the acetylcholine can be released and it can act on the muscarinic receptors. When these muscarinic receptors are activated, they can be coupled with the different types of secondary messenger system. So one of the secondary messenger system is the PLC, phospholipase C. This phospholipase C, when it is going to be activated, it can cleave the phosphatidyl inositol biphosphate into two important components. One is the IP3, inositol triphosphate, and second one is the DAG, diacylglycerol. Now these two mediators are responsible for the increased intracellular calcium levels within the GA smooth muscle. This diacylglycerol, DAG, can further activate the protein kinase C, which are going to stimulate the inward going calcium channels. Now the calcium can enter into the GA smooth muscle, and IP3 can also increase the intracellular calcium stores. So these two mediators can increase the intracellular calcium levels within the GA smooth muscle. In this way, acetylcholine can increase the intracellular calcium levels within the GA smooth muscle, resulting in the contraction. Now, dicyclomine acts as an antagonist at the acetylcholine receptors. So, dicyclomine is a competitive antagonist. It can bind to the muscarinic receptors such that these receptors are inactivated. In this way, dicyclomine prevents the binding of acetylcholine to the muscarinic receptors, thereby prevents the GA smooth muscle contraction. In this way, dicyclomine acts as an antispasmodic. But at the same time, dicyclomine can also inhibit the effects of other mediators. For example, GA smooth muscle is equipped with few of the receptors like the H1 receptors on which the histamine can act, as well as it is equipped with the bradykinin receptors on which the bradykinin can act. Now this dicyclomine can bind to these H1 receptors, thereby it can inhibit its activity, as well as it can also inhibit the bradykinin receptors and again inhibits its activity. So when these two receptors are inhibited, histamine as well as the bradykinin cannot act on these receptors. In this way, dicyclomine can also prevent the muscle contraction produced by histamine as well as the bradykinin. So all of these actions of dicyclomine results in the antispasmodic activity. What are the pharmacological actions? The important pharmacological action of dicyclomine is on the GA smooth muscle. So on the GA tract, different types of muscarinic receptors like M1 and M2 receptors are present. Now dicyclomine can block this M1 and M2 receptors, resulting in the relaxation and decreased GA motility, and therefore it produces some antispasmodic activity. That's why dicyclomine can be used in the treatment of irritable bowel syndrome. But as the motility is reduced, this drug can also produce some constipation as the side effect. Similarly, another important organ is the heart. On the heart, M2 receptors are present. Now dicyclomine can block these M2 receptors, which results in the increased rate of contraction. So dicyclomine can produce some tachycardia. It can produce some palpitations, awareness of heartbeat and tachyarrhythmias because of block of M2 receptors. And dicyclomine can also reduce the exocrine secretions. It can decrease the lacrimal secretion, which may result in the blurred vision. And it can decrease the salivary secretion, resulting in the dry mouth. And it can also reduce the sweat secretion, which may increase the hyperthermia. What are the precautions? One of the important precautions of dicyclomine is, as we have seen, dicyclomine can reduce the sweat secretion. As the sweat secretion is reduced, heat dissipation is also reduced, which may increase the heat stroke as well as the fever. So dicyclomine is having a risk of heat stroke in the elevated temperatures. Similarly, dicyclomine can increase the drowsiness in the patients, as well as it can also produce some confusion, alteration of the mental status. And apart from these central effects, it can also produce some blurred vision. So all of these effects may impair the motor activity of the patients. So working performance with the machinery can be reduced. So whenever dicyclomine is prescribed for a longer period, the patient should be given precaution such that the drowsiness and blurred vision may impair their working activity. Another important precautions are other central side effects. Dicyclomine can produce disorientation and hallucination. Some wrong perception can be observed, and ataxia, loss of balance, insomnia, lack of sleep, all these can be observed with the dicyclomine. Similarly, it can also produce few of the cardiovascular side effects. Particularly, it's an anticholinergic, thereby it can inhibit the M2 receptors present on the heart, which results in the increased rate of cardiac contraction. So dicyclomine can produce the tachycardia, and it can increase the tachyarrhythmias. So whenever dicyclomine is going to be prescribed, these symptoms should be closely monitored. What are the side effects? The first and important side effect is the dry mouth. Since it is an anticholinergic, it decreases the salivary secretion and it produces the dry mouth as the important side effect. And another important side effect is the blurred vision. This is again because of the reduction of the lacrimal secretions. And it can also produce nausea and vomiting and constipation. Since this drug acts as an antispasmodic, it can produce a constipation as the one of the important side effect. And we can also observe few of the central side effects like the dizziness, drowsiness, confusion, nervousness in the patients, and tachycardia, as well as palpitations. Awareness of heartbeat can also be observed in the patients who are treated with the dicyclomine. How it is given? Dicyclomine is given as a tablet form at a dose of 20 mg, and it is also available as a capsule form at dose of 10 mg. Even it is supplied as a syrup at a dose of 10 mg per 5 ml. And dose may be initially started at 10 mg or it may be increased to that 20 mg. So that's about the dicyclomine. Dicyclomine is an anticholinergic and antispasmodic. It is particularly indicated for the irritable bowel syndrome. This drug is going to inhibit the muscarinic receptors on the GI smooth muscle. Thereby it reduces the GI motility. That's why it reduces the symptoms of irritable bowel syndrome. Since this drug is an anticholinergic, it can produce some blurred vision, dry mouth, constipation as important side effects. And it can also increase the central side effects like the dizziness and drowsiness, and cardiovascular side effects like tachycardia and palpitations. All these should be carefully monitored when the dicyclomine is used for longer periods. So that's about the dicyclomine. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.